Welcome to part 4 of my Unitail crash course. This episode is the much anticipated introduction to wave creation. We're gonna discuss what wave scripts are and how they work, I'll teach you how to create and move a bullet, and finally we'll program a simple wave using the things we've learned. Let's take a look at the wave we're about to create. It's very simple and not very impressive looking, but that's for a good reason. Even if the wave is very simple, creating it requires you to understand a few very important things beforehand. This tutorial will focus on understanding wave scripts first, so that we can create flashy waves in future episodes of this series. This tutorial is part 4 in a series of videos, so please watch the earlier parts first. They explain a lot of the things we'll be using in this episode. If you encounter a nasty error while following this tutorial, please, please, please don't copy and paste it into a comment and expect me to immediately figure it out. Try helping yourself by looking at the error message in detail and checking your code. All mods created in this series can be downloaded via a Google Drive link in the description, so you can download them and compare their code to yours. If you really can't figure it out, you can always ask the Unitail subreddit and Discord for help. By the way, be sure to join my own Discord, where you can discuss the series in great detail. Lastly, we're using the latest version of Create Your Frisk, the new and improved version of Unitail. That's a long enough intro, let's finally start coding. Like the tutorials before, it's best to copy the Encounter Skeleton mod and change it instead of changing the original. What are wave scripts and where can you find them? Great question, creator. First, the where. Wave scripts are located in your Waves folder, which is inside of your Lua folder. Now the what. Each Lua file in this folder is one wave or attack. All functionality of a wave is defined inside of a wave script. This would be the spawning and moving of bullets and maybe some visual effects and sounds accompanying the attacks. Let's create a text file and turn it into a Lua file by changing its ending from .txt to .lua. You might get a warning doing so, but there's nothing to worry about. Name the file attack1. Before we can actually see our wave in Unitail, we need to change our encounter script so our newly created wave will be used as an attack. Open it and set the table possible_attacks to just attack1. This ensures that only our wave will be used as a possible attack, which is great for testing. Next, open your wave script. We need to add the update function. It is required for every wave script or else Unitail will give you an error when the wave starts. It can be empty, it just has to exist somewhere. The update function runs every frame while the attack is active. Unitail normally runs at 60 FPS or frames per second, so the update function runs 60 times per second. It usually contains most of the wave's code. Let's finally spawn a bullet. To create a bullet, use the function createProjectile. Add it before our update function, because we only want to create the bullet once and not every frame. Looking at the documentation, it becomes clear that the function needs three arguments. First, the name of the sprite the bullet will use. And lastly, the spawn coordinates x and y. Let me explain all three arguments in more detail. The sprite argument uses a PNG file from the sprites folder, which is located directly inside of your mod folder. Inside of it, you should find bullet.png. To use this image as the bullet sprite, simply write the name of the image without the .png at the end, so bullet. For our coordinates x and y, you need to understand how coordinate systems work. Hopefully you've learned about them in school, otherwise God help you. Okay, I'll give you a refresher. This is how our coordinate system looks like. This point represents the bullet, the numbers in the brackets from left to right are x and y. The x value determines where a bullet is located horizontally. Increasing the x value moves the bullet to the right, decreasing it moves the bullet to the left. Negative values can be coordinates as well. The y value, on the other hand, determines where the bullet is located vertically. Increasing the y value moves the bullet up, and I think you can guess what decreasing the value does. The origin in Unitail, so where the x and y axis meet, is the center of the arena where your soul is located when the wave starts. Be careful when setting x and y to very high or very low values. The bullet might not show up. It still spawns, but it's gonna be somewhere outside of your game window. Now that we know how to spawn a bullet, the obvious question is how to move bullet. But let's not get ahead of ourselves. We first need to learn about the bullet object. A bullet object represents a spawned bullet and contains all of its information like its sprite and coordinates. In order to move a bullet, we need this bullet object. To create it, add the name your bullet object should have and an equal sign before the create projectile function. Let's finally There are different functions for moving a bullet, but the only one we'll be using in this tutorial is simply called move and requires two arguments, x and y. This function offsets the bullet from its current position by the x and y values specified. So, for example, writing move 1, 0 will move the bullet 1 pixel to the right. X and y, once again, are coordinates, but this time the origin, or 0, 0, is the current position of the bullet. Because we want our bullet to move more than once, we need to put the code responsible for it in the update function. Write the name of our bullet object, then a dot, and then move 1, 0. Now, when the wave starts, we see a little bullet slowly moving to the right. Experiment around with different values for movement. See if you can't get the bullet to move faster or diagonally. The last thing we need before we can create our final wave is the so-called wave timer. It is a variable created by us which counts how many times the update function was called since the wave has started. To create it, simply create a variable called wave timer at the start of the wave and set it to 0. At the end of the update function, write wave timer equals wave timer plus 1. This increases the value of the variable by 1 every time the update function reaches its end. Let's finally create our wave. Spawn a bullet with the bullet.png sprite at x30 and y30, so to the top right of our soul. Create a bullet object like I've shown you before. Then add an if statement. Check if the wave timer is smaller than 60, if so, move the bullet down. Because Unitail runs at 60 FPS, the wave timer increases by a total of 60 every second. This means that the if statement is only true for the first second of the wave. Because of that, the code inside of it will only run for 1 second, causing the bullet to move down a bit. Next, create an if-else statement. Check if the wave timer is smaller than 120, and if so, move the bullet to the left. This if-else statement is connected to the if statement above and will only run if the wave timer is smaller than 120, so if the wave has been active for less than 2 seconds. But because the first if statement is true for the first second of the wave, the code inside of this if-else statement will only run during the second second of the wave. Well, that sounded weird. Finally, add 2 more if-else statements. Check once for wave timer smaller than 180, and the other time for wave timer smaller than 240. Move the bullet up and right respectively. And there we have it, our final bullet movement. I hope you've learned something in this tutorial. If you did, a like and subscribe would be greatly appreciated. If something wasn't clear enough, I'll gladly provide answers in the comments. The last few tutorials of my crash course will dive into sprites, audio, and more complex wave creation. We will look at spawning, moving, and removing multiple bullets during a wave in part 5. Stay tuned! Creator out!